Marginal propensity to consume is defined as the share of additional income that a consumer spends on consumption. That means it describes the percentage of a pay raise consumers spend on buying goods and services instead of saving. We can calculate the marginal propensity to consume by following a simple three-step process. First, we identify the change in income. Second, we identify the change in consumption. Third, we divide the change in consumption by the change in income. Let's start with step one, identifying the change in income. The change in income is commonly written as delta Y. It describes the change in the level of income between a certain point in the past and a more recent point in time. Therefore, to identify the change in income, all we have to do is subtract the old income from the new income. To give an example, let's say you have a friend. We'll call her Emily. Emily works as a waitress and earns $25,000 a year. Because she's such a hardworking employee, Emily is soon promoted to restaurant manager. After the promotion, she earns $30,000 a year. Now, if we subtract the initial $25,000 from the new $30,000, we can see that Emily's change in income adds up to $5,000 a year. Now let's move on to step two, identifying the change in consumption. Finding the change in consumption, which is also known as delta C, works just like identifying the change in income. Only this time, we are looking for the difference in the level of consumption before and after a change in income. To do that, we simply subtract the consumption before the change, that is the old consumption, from the consumption after the change, that is the new consumption. To illustrate this, let's assume that before her promotion, Emily spent about $20,000 a year on consumption. That includes all kinds of expenditures, such as rent, food, clothing, and many other things. After the promotion, Emily decides to use some of her additional money to go on vacation. As a result, her consumption spending increases from $20,000 to $23,000. Now, if we subtract the initial $20,000 from the new $23,000, we find that the change in Emily's consumption is $3,000. Alright, now on to the third and final step, dividing the change in consumption by the change in income. We can calculate the marginal propensity to consume by dividing the change in consumption by the change in income. The result of this division can range from 0 to 1. If all additional income is used for consumption, delta Y is equal to delta C, which results in a value of 1. Meanwhile, if none of the additional income is used for consumption, delta C is 0, which results in a marginal propensity to consume of 0. In the case of your friend Emily, we know that the change in income is $5,000 and the resulting change in consumption is $3,000. If we divide the $3,000 by the $5,000, we can see that her marginal propensity to consume is 0.6. That means she spends 60% of her additional income on consumption. By contrast, if Emily decided to spend all of her additional income, her marginal propensity to consume would be $5,000 divided by $5,000, which is equal to 1 or 100%. On the other hand, if she decided to save all of her additional money, her marginal propensity to consume would be 0 divided by $5,000, which is equal to 0. And that's it. So let's sum it up once again. Marginal propensity to consume is defined as the share of additional income that a consumer spends on consumption. It can be calculated as the change in consumption, delta C, divided by the change in income, delta Y. The value of the marginal propensity to consume can range from 0 to 1. If all additional income is used for consumption, delta Y is equal to delta C, which results in a value of 1. Meanwhile, if none of the additional income is used for consumption, delta C is 0, which results in a marginal propensity to consume of 0.